What we have here is a Caterpillar, this is a Caterpillar C11 engine. We're looking at the performance of this engine on second generation renewable fuels. What is different about their combustion characteristics? How might we change the characteristics of how these fuels are made in order to make them more suitable for use in engines? This project, which was is an IREE project, started us off on this idea of working with hydrogen to modify combustion. And now we have a discovery grant in which we're looking at really the same general idea, where we're converting fuels into hydrogen-rich gases. With that kind of combustion system, you can get the efficiency of a diesel engine, but very low emissions and much simpler emission control. And that's the promise of low-temperature combustion.
This process is looking at pre-extraction of wood chips before they go into the pulping process. And the idea is to take part of the hemicellulose out of the wood chips before they go into the exactly the same pulping process. If I take the hemicellulose out, I use less chemicals in the process and I use less cooking time. So it's actually an advantage of taking it out up front, making fermentable sugars from it, and fermenting them either to ethanol or to some other bioproduct. We're kind of hoping that we can convince some of the paper industry around here to give it a try. I haven't really worked with the aspect of looking at biomass for the bioenergy, and I think the IREE grants gave me the opportunity to start in that field.
We're working on solar thermal systems for buildings. These are systems that you can use in your home, and currently they're used primarily to heat water. So you'll have a collector up on your roof, and that collector gathers the solar radiation, and then it's converted to heated water. We look at materials that could replace the materials that are conventionally used in these types of systems. So for example, right now, if you look at a solar thermal collector for a home, it'll be made out of copper and glass. The price of copper has increased fourfold in just a few years, and so it's very important to start to think about alternative materials that can take us into the future. We do quite a bit of work with polymer materials. Some of the work out of our laboratory has actually gone from research level to marketplace, and there's now a new polymer-based solar collector system that is available to purchase now, and much of that development work came out of our laboratory.
Chlamydomonas is a model system for studying green algae, and there are two aspects of algae that are important for energy research right now. One is biohydrogen production, and the second is biomass. So like other green algae, Chlamydomonas has hydrogenase genes, which are turned on in anaerobic conditions. In terms of thinking about producing hydrogen from Chlamydomonas or other green algae, we need to understand how the hydrogenase genes are regulated. So this work is funded by our grant from IREE, and I think it would not have been possible for us to begin this new research direction if it were not for the IREE work.
Gasification is really an old technology, and it was around in the 1800s. The gasification process combusts plant material under oxygen-starved conditions and produces an intermediary gas called a producer gas, which behaves a lot like natural gas. And so we're taking plant material and creating a substitute natural gas. IREE really deserves a great deal of credit on seeing what the potential was of this. And they played a very instrumental role in providing the first dollars to really go into this project. And so they've really set the stage for Morris to move to the next step, which is to be carbon neutral by 2010.
We're really trying to work with the people who are producing these new renewable fuels and the people who make engines, and we're working together to try and understand how do we create a new generation of fuels and engines based on biofuels rather than based on conventional petroleum.
I think there is a tremendous opportunity to find new enzymes, find new ways of breaking the biomass down.
Solar thermal systems for homes are going to have a huge impact in the future as energy costs go up.
Chlamydomonas and other green algae have two problems that need to be solved for biohydrogen production.
One of our next steps is to really start looking at what other biofuels could be considered as good candidates for thermal conversion of carbon.
We wouldn't be in this business if it weren't for IREE.